not gone into any Modi bashing. Would you like to detach from it so that, like, should we discuss Modi? I don't want to.
Hey, shut up, ya Kunal.
Shut up, ya Kunal.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of Shut Up Ya Kunal. Today with me is Kavita Krishnan, who's a communist and a feminist and an activist.
Yeah.
I mean, when I go through your Twitter timeline, I'm just making your intro out of what you get trolled on.
Yeah,
you get trolled on being a communist, then being a feminist, and then being an activist.
First, I plead tonight to the left liberals to understand there is nothing in the world called being a left liberal. Because leftists cannot be liberal, and those who are liberal cannot be leftist. This is my firm view. It's the most oxymoronic two words with a hyphen in between them. And especially when there are people like Kavita Krishnan.
You know, you've come in interesting times, though.
Yeah.
The left is losing all elections, statues are falling down, and it's a tough time that the left is seeing in India. What do you really have to say about the Tripura election results?
See, I think that, you know, elections are things which, you know, the left has been winning that election for 25 years. You know, CPM has, left front, won that election for 25 years, and now they lost this time. So I think, you know, I see it as partly as anti-incumbency, and partly I'm sure it'll take time to figure out what mistakes they may have made and how they could have done better. That's different. I say the left lost in Bengal, not Tripura, Bengal, because the left moved away from its own values. It started, instead of standing up against land grab by corporates, they grabbed land for corporates. It was Singur and Nandigram, okay? That was what did them in Bengal. So, in fact, it vindicates the left. Even the left's own defeat vindicates the values of the left, okay, over there.
And left ka akhri lal khila sirf Keral mein bacha hai. Matlab, left ka hal Congress se bhi pura hai. 2019 tak. Congress or left mukt ho jayega.
Thank you very much for joining us, Mr. Ram Madhav. Congratulations to you. You have demonstrated that the BJP can actually raise a cadre right from scratch in the space of 8 to 10 months. How did you manage that in Tripura?
Money, 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 money.
The BJP didn't just earn 1,034 crores between 2016 and 17. It basically made up the mass of the total earnings of all seven national parties.
What I've noticed is, from my limited knowledge of politics, is that without a Reliance logo in the background, it's very difficult to win elections. The logistical trouble in contesting elections and the way elections are run and the money you need on ground to support the... it's very tough.
It's tough. I'll say it's muscle power as well as money. And money, you're absolutely right. The point is that I think that it is not impossible even then to win an election. If you think of winning elections and winning other battles on the same continuum, okay? Winning anything for a good cause is difficult, okay? Because money is never going to support it. Why should they? It goes against their interests. Capitalists are not going to support it. Why should they? But it's possible to win because in a democracy, I think, you know, the idea that it is possible for people to win in spite of all this is an important idea to hold on to. And I think that if there were some electoral reforms, things could be even better.
कॉमन सेंस की बात है कि देखिए प्रॉब्लम यह है कि इलेक्शन में जो करप्शन है वो देश की सारी करप्शन का रूट है फाउंडेशन है क्योंकि होता क्या है कि जब आप करोड़ों रुपए इलेक्शन में खर्च करेंगे तो करोड़ों आपने जमा करने पड़ेंगे और अभी आपने दिखाया कि किस तरह 80% जो उसकी कलेक्शन है उसके सोर्स पता नहीं वो ब्लैक मनी किसकी है वो ड्रग मनी हो सकती है वो क्राइम माफिया की हो सकती है रियल एस्टेट माफिया की हो सकती है फॉरेन मनी हो सकती है कुछ पता ही नहीं एंड माइंड यू व्हेन द गवर्नमेंट केम डाउन हेवीली ऑन द एनजीओज देयर लॉजिक वाज दैट दीज एनजीओज आर बीइंग फंडेड फ्रॉम अब्रॉड to disrupt India's politics. Now, if that was a suspicion, now the same foreign funding has now become noble and nice.
Exactly.
Now, corporates will be running the political parties, will be running India's politics.
Remember that the BJP was not in power till the late 80s, okay? RSS has been in this country since 1925, exactly since when the Communist Party was. Okay,
right.
But at a point, they managed to change public opinion in their favor. My point is, why do we assume that that is impossible for the left to do also? The left has done it in some states. Okay, it has done it in some pockets. Now, today it's losing, but the point is, when you see the Congress losing, when you see the BJP losing, you don't say, oh, they're dead and gone forever. Those who say that about the left are hoping not going to happen. And there are other victories also. You know, as I keep saying, I'm not saying elections are unimportant. Mm. But for instance, if you ask me about the victories that the CPIML has won, okay, I would say that among those huge victories is a change that is physically felt and remembered by people on the ground in, for instance, central Bihar, okay, where you had terribly feudal practices, where a Dalit laborer, landless laborer, could not sit aamne-saamne like this in front of a landlord and bargain for his or her wages, okay. The change in the confidence, the sheer confidence that the poor got there, was because of CPIML's movements. And that is why they also, because they didn't see the fight for land and wages as being separate from the right to cast a vote and the right to vote for CPIML. So they did all those things. They got hit for it. The Ranveer Sena was formed, there were massacres, you know, people were killed for supporting this party, for electing two MLAs. The massacres began because two MLAs were elected from the CPIML.
ये तस्वीरें 1998 में हुए लक्ष्मणपुर बाथे नरसंहार की हैं, जिसमें दलितों के पूरे गांव में हिंसा का तांडव मचा था। इल्जाम लगा था रणवीर सेना पर, लेकिन इस हत्याकांड के आरोपी अदालत से बरी हो गए थे। लेकिन स्टिंग ऑपरेशन में रणवीर सेना के इन 6 कमांडरों ने बताया है कि किस तरह ये आरोपी पूरी प्लानिंग के साथ एक युद्ध की तरह इन हत्याओं को अंजाम देते थे। कुल मिलाकर बच्चों और महिलाओं समेत 144 लोगों को मार दिया गया था।
This month, called by the Communist Party of India, Marxist-Leninist, to protest the acquittal by a court in Bihar's Jahanabad of all 24 upper caste men accused of murdering 23 women, children, and men at Arwal's Shankar Bigha village in 1999.
You know, you asked why contest elections. My thing is that a lot of our opponents, basically, they would be happy if we were willing just to be lobbyists, ki tum log acha kaam karo, but don't lay a claim to power. My point is, it's not the point is, the left stands for the poorest people, and it is their being in power. It's not about a left party being in power, not. It is about them being able to overturn a terribly unequal political structure, to actually get a measure of control over their own lives. That is the idea of a left being in, being in control of things. You know, the left remains alive when it is among people and among struggling people in an unequal society, right? So, which is why I think people are so surprised that, arey, we just managed to say that we've wiped the left out of everywhere except Kerala and JNU. And now they see the sea of people, peasants with red flags in Mumbai. Okay. And they say, where did they come from?
Almost 25,000 farmers are on a 180-kilometer march from Nashik to Mumbai.
CPIM के अखिल भारतीय किसान सभा की ओर से आयोजित इस मार्च में अनुमान यह है कि 1,00,000 किसान सोमवार सुबह विधानसभा का घेराव कर सकते।
आज 70 साल में इस देश की एग्रीकल्चर पॉलिसी नहीं, आपने देखी है इस देश की एग्रीकल्चर पॉलिसी, ना कांग्रेस ने बनाई ना बीजेपी ने बनाई। जब आपकी एग्रीकल्चर पॉलिसी ही नहीं है तो किसको पता आप एग्रीकल्चर में क्या कर रहे हैं। आज बाजार में कोई भी फ्रूट सब्जी फल ले लीजिए, आप कोई भी चीज दिल्ली में 40-50 रुपए से कम नहीं, उसी चीज का किसान को व्यापारी 5 रुपए देता है। हिंदुस्तान में हर नेता, हर पॉलिटिशियन, हर ब्यूरोक्रेट को पता है कि 5 रुपए की चीज 50 रुपए में बिक रही है। जितनी एपीएमसी मंडीज हैं, उनके सारे ऑफिस बियरर्स किसी ना किसी पॉलिटिकल पार्टी से जुड़े हुए हैं। ये जो अनअकाउंटेड मनी है, ये जो 40 रुपए है ना, इस पे कोई बिल इशू नहीं होता है, इस पे कोई टैक्स नहीं देता है, ये कहां जाता है किसी को नहीं पता, ये सारा पॉलिटिकल फंडिंग में जाता है। और ट्रेजेडी इस देश की ये है कि गरीब किसान, जिसको मैं कहता हूं कि पुअर फार्मर, इज सब्सिडाइजिंग अर्बन रिच।
एंड व्हाई वर दे कमिंग? दे वर कमिंग नॉट बिकॉज दे थिंक वी आर कमिंग फॉर सम एब्स्ट्रैक्ट पार्टी, ना, दे वर कमिंग बिकॉज दे सेड वी आर कमिंग फॉर आवरसेल्व्स, वी आर कमिंग फॉर आवर स्ट्रगल्स, वी आर कमिंग बिकॉज वी वॉन्ट टू विन दिस स्ट्रगल।
जब ये किसान चले तो 2 दिनों तक उनका अपना खाना था उनके पास, मगर उनके इरादे ने रास्ते में पड़ने वाले कस्बों और शहरों को बदलना शुरू कर दिया। आम लोग पूरी तैयारी के साथ आ गए, किसानों की मदद के लिए खड़े हो गए। मुंबई के डब्बा वाले भी खाना लेकर आ गए, खालसा एड के लोग भी पानी की बोतल लेकर सुबह दोपहर बांटने लगे। इनके साथ डॉक्टरों की टीम थी जो किसानों के पांव की मरहम पट्टी करने लगी। यही नहीं, जब इनके जत्थे रात को सुमाया ग्राउंड से आजाद मैदान की तरफ बढ़ने लगे तो स्थानीय लोगों ने बुजुर्ग किसानों को अपनी गाड़ी में बिठाकर आजाद मैदान तक पहुंचाया। दूसरा, जब हम बेखबर रहे मुंबई की, ये लोग हिंदुस्तान के उस हिस्से के लिए जाग रहे थे जो अपने अकेलेपन में न जाने कितने साल से फांसी के फंदे पर लटक रहे थे।
You know, it just made me so sad and almost ashamed of my country when I saw news channels debating who's funding this when the left march happened.
Look, I frankly will tell you, I don't feel sad. I feel extremely amused at that, okay? I'll tell you why. Because the poor, sad things, they really think in terms of, see, for them everything is funded, na? Unko to malum hai ki unke kisi rally mein logon ko lana bhi hai, to unko paise deke lane hai. ठीक है, नीतीश कुमार के गवर्नमेंट को बिहार में अभी वो एंटी डाउरी कोई ह्यूमन चेन कराना था, उसमें आ पीपल वेंट एंड स्पोक टू द वुमेन स्टैंडिंग इन द चेन एंड दे ऑल सर हमें बताया गया था ब्लैंकेट मिलेगा।
राहुल गांधी आए खाट सभा में और चले भी गए, लेकिन उनकी खटिया खड़ी हो गई है। यहाँ जो लोग आए थे वो खाट लेकर निकल पड़े हैं। भैया खाट लेकर कहाँ जा रहे हो?
जा रहे हैं लोग घर पे सर।
आइए मैं आपको तस्वीर दिखाता हूँ जहाँ पे राहुल गांधी खड़े थे। ये घमासान मचा है, आपाधापी मारा मारी मची हुई है। ये देखिए, ये एक नहीं ये दो दो लेके जा रहे हैं। अरे भैया क्यों झगड़ रहे हैं आप लोग? अरे कहाँ झगड़ रहे हैं? ये देखिए।
खाने के लिए मारामारी हो गई, खाने के पैकेट लेने के लिए लूट सी मच गई, लोग एक दूसरे के ऊपर चढ़ने लगे। पूरा पंडाल किसी युद्ध के मैदान सा नजर आया। इस कार्यक्रम में बीजेपी अध्यक्ष अमित शाह और यूपी के सीएम योगी आदित्यनाथ पहुंचे थे। तस्वीरें गवाह हैं कि यहां स्वच्छता अभियान की धज्जियां उड़ाकर रख दी गई। बताया जा रहा है कि जब इस गंदगी को कैमरे में कैद करने की कोशिश की गई तो कुछ कार्यकर्ताओं ने मीडिया कर्मियों के साथ भी बदसलूकी की।
What do you think Lenin got to the table which was so disturbing that the first thing the BJP did was topple the statue?
Look, I think that, to me, I've been thinking recently about why somebody like Bhagat Singh when as a young man, he and his comrades, why did they pick up Lenin and start reading? Why is the last book he was reading something that Lenin wrote, right? And to say that, arey, wo to foreigner tha, he has nothing to do with India. Then what about Ambedkar? What about Periyar? What about Gandhi? You're knocking down all those statues. And clearly they do have a lot to do with India. So the idea is actually they're not, the common factor between Lenin and all those others is not foreigner and Indian. The common factor is that they all stood for fighting against inequality, that they stand for some values that the fascists despise, that they're scared of, which is why they're knocking them down.
Another statue, just the second one in the space of 24 hours being brought down. And all of this is coming just, 48 hours after that historic victory of the BJP. Excited by what happened in Tripura, BJP leader in Tamil Nadu, H. Raja, has also called for the demolition of the statues of Periyar.
ये महात्मा गांधी को भी नहीं बख्शा गया है। ये देखिए किस तरह से उनके चश्मे को तोड़ दिया गया। देखिए जो नफरतों का सिलसिला शुरू हुआ लेनिन से, वो अब देश के अलग अलग हिस्सों में दिखाई दे रहा है। जो लोग इसके पीछे हैं वो आखिर इस नफरत को किस हद तक ले जाना चाहते हैं?
Can you assure, last question, can you assure that there won't be further statues that will be brought down in Tripura?
I am not an astrologer and therefore I cannot assure anything further.
In fact, I am saying demolish more statues. The more statues they'll demolish, the more people will want to read about and know about what is happening. Okay? Someone I'm very close to teaches in college, and he told me that the day the statue was demolished, the next day he was taking an economics class. It was Women's Day, International Women's Day. And they actually ended up discussing International Women's Day, searching on their phones what Periyar said about women, what Lenin said about women, and having an eye-opener like, wow, is this what they said? And so they were reading a lot more Lenin and Periyar than they would have done had the statue not been demolished.
अरे भाई ये लेनिन है कौन? लेनिन ने रशिया में, रूस में दुनिया का पहला सोशलिस्ट राष्ट्र की स्थापना की थी। तो उन्होंने क्या किया? लैंड रिफॉर्म जिसको कहते हैं, बड़े किसानों से जमीन छीनी, गरीबों में बांट दी। मजदूर उस वक्त 14, 15, 16, 17 घंटे काम करते थे। लॉ लाया गया कि कोई भी मजदूर को 8 घंटे से ज्यादा काम नहीं करना पड़ेगा। महिलाओं को मिले समान अधिकार, ये बोल्शेविक पार्टी के अंदर ही महिलाओं का रोल बहुत स्ट्रांग था।
There's something that Eduardo Galeano, this lovely Latin American writer, he said about Che Guevara, which I think fits for the left at its best, okay? He said about Che that, why does Che, the image of Che and the idea of Che refuse to die in spite of so many things? And he said maybe it's because Che said what he thought and did what he said. And in a world where words and deeds are such strangers to each other, that if they meet on the street, they don't say hello because they don't recognize each other. Mm. Your own words and your own deeds, okay?
आप मुझे कल्पना कर सकते हैं, जब किसी छोटी बालिका पर बलात्कार होता है, कितनी दर्दनाक घटना है जी। लेकिन क्या हम ये कहेंगे कि तुम्हारी सरकार में इतने होते थे, मेरी सरकार में इतने होते हैं? मैं समझता हूं इससे बड़ा गलत रास्ता नहीं हो सकता है।
देश में क्राइम अगेंस्ट विमेन, इसका अगर रिकॉर्ड देखा जाए तो देश में जो पहले 10 राज्य हैं, पहले 10 में 7 राज्य कांग्रेस पार्टी रूल स्टेट है, 10 में से 7।
आप जब वोट करने जाए तब पल भर के लिए उस निर्भया को याद करना जिसके कारण आपको दिल्ली की हर बहन बेटी याद आएगी और तब जाकर के कब्र के निशान पर वोट दबाना।
लेकिन क्या हम ये कहेंगे कि तुम्हारी सरकार में इतने होते थे, मेरी सरकार में इतने होते हैं? मैं समझता हूं इससे बड़ा गलत रास्ता नहीं हो सकता है।
यहां पड़ोस में बीदर में दलित बेटी के साथ क्या हुआ था, ये सोशल मीडिया में आज भी पड़ा हुआ है। कैंडल मार्च निकालने वाले मैं कांग्रेस के लोगों से पूछ रहा हूं, जब बीजल में दलित बेटी पर इतना अत्याचार हुआ तो ये तुम्हारी कैंडल लाइटें कहां खो गई थी, तुम्हारे नेता कहां खो गए? मैंने कहा हिपोक्रेसी की भी सीमा होती है।
I mean, I'll tell you my position on it. I think a left is a beautiful mechanism to keep the right in check. But I would not know if India was ruled 60, 65 years by a left party. I can actually not say where the country would be. I know socially it would be in a better place. But economically, I don't know where it would be.
See, I think the interesting thing is that you make that distinction between the social and the economic, which I think is not really a correct distinction. Hmm. I think that it is proven the world over that social indicators are better when there's less inequality, economic inequality as well. So actually, the idea that you can have an economic way of organizing society that is less unequal is not a completely wild and crazy one. My point is, you're not asking how has capitalism been doing? We were told, for instance, in India in the 1990s, that when I was a young student, people were saying it's stupid to talk about left values, all that is outdated. And they said that neoliberal policies in India are going to make India a better place. You will get better jobs, you're opening up the economy. Whereas now, you've just had a recent study by Thomas Piketty, and there was this paper that came out, you may have seen it, which shows that if you look at since the 90s to now, in India and in the world, inequality has reached the same levels that were there in 1920s. Okay, worse than they were in 1920s in colonial India. Okay,
the best way to describe it is British Raj to the billionaire Raj. So stark and so large is the gap that 1% of your population is actually contributing 22% of the income.
Or sir, jo bottom 50% hai na, sir, aapke farmers, daily wagers, small shopkeepers, factory workers, chai walas, etc. They only earned 1% of the wealth that the nation created. Factor in inflation, sir, half of India became poorer in 2017.
भाइयों बहनों, गांव के लोगों को भी टीवी देखने का मन करता है कि नहीं करता है? उनको भी तो कभी सांस कभी बहुत ही देखने का मन करता है कि नहीं करता है? लेकिन बिजली नहीं होगी तो बेचारे कहां से देखेंगे? उनको भी तो कभी सांस कभी बहुत ही देखने का मन करता है कि नहीं करता है?
So what is that saying? Clearly that's doing terribly badly, right? So my point is, instead of being so certain that the right is economics is doing good, it's a good job, even economically they're doing badly, right? If they're not doing what they promised to do, which is to create jobs and reduce inequality, that didn't happen. The opposite happened, right?
अब थोड़ा सा सर आपसे चर्चा शुरू करना चाहता हूँ मैं इकोनॉमी को लेकर के, और मेरा ख्याल है कि आप ये मानते हैं कि इकोनॉमी की हालत बहुत ख़राब है, लेकिन ये रूलिंग पार्टी के नैरेटिव से अलग बात आप कह रहे हैं। उनका कहना है कि कमाल का विकास हो रहा है, कमाल की नौकरियां बटी हैं।
इकोनॉमिक्स में एक भी व्यक्ति बता दीजिए आज हमारे कैबिनेट में जिसको इकोनॉमिक समझ में आती है, एक भी नहीं है। बैंक के पास पैसा ही नहीं है, लोग आज बैंक में पैसा भी नहीं रख रहे हैं। जाके पता ये करिए कि डिपॉजिट किस रेट में ग्रो कर रही है, पता करिए कि कितना क्रेडिट एडवांस हो रहा है,
और जीडीपी का 7.7 का नंबर हमको दिखा देते हैं।
तो मैं आज नरेंद्र मोदी को भी यही कहता हूँ, कभी इकोनॉमिक परफॉर्मेंस में चुनाव नहीं जीता जाता है।
हिंदुत्व पर फोकस करो, चुनाव जीतना जरूरी है। सर ये तो पावर के पीछे भागने वाली बात
है। नहीं नहीं, देखो पावर तो चुनाव किसके लिए है, पावर नहीं है। मुसलमानों में महिलाओं को अलग कर दो, ट्रिपल तलाक देकर ये करके बोरा सिया इन सबको भी अलग कर दो, और ये सुन्नी जो है और ख़ासतौर वो वहाबी सुन्नी है उसको अलग कर दो, तो फिर हम जीतेंगे। उस फार्मूला में हमें मेजॉरिटी मिली। ये गवर्नेंस वावर्नेंस ये सब कहने की बात है, उस पर नहीं जीते।
ओवैसी के ओवैसी ने जो बोला था ना 15 मिनट के लिए पुलिस हटा दो, उसके कारण हिंदू ने भाजपा को वोट दिया है। भाजपा सरकार को भाजपा के वादों पे नहीं मिला। बीजेपी की सरकार क्यों आ रही है? सड़क वगैरह के लिए नहीं, नौकरी के लिए नहीं।
अच्छा, तो आपको नौकरी नहीं चाहिए, आपको सड़क नहीं चाहिए, आपको घर नहीं चाहिए, ये सब आपको आपको नहीं चाहिए।
हमारा आत्मसम्मान चाहिए हमको सबसे पहले।
अच्छा,
हमारा आत्मसम्मान चाहिए हमको सबसे पहले।
अच्छा।
So why is the left so heavily discussed only negatively on every news channel? Why do you think that happens?
See, I think, and I have a rather sober explanation for it. I see what is happening as similar to what happened in the 1930s in Germany. And that's why I'm not persuaded even by those on the left who say that, oh, you know, fascism is not happening in India, it's not fascism yet. Huh? The point is that fascism is going to come dressed in whatever clothes are local clothes. Na? Wo wahi concentration camp wale kapde pehenge nahi aane wala, so that you can recognize and say, arre, Auschwitz jaisa camp yahan ban gaya, tab to pata hai. It's going to come, here you're having the lynch mobs. You had lynch mobs in Germany too. You had anti-Jewish sentiment. You had people saying the Jews are and the blacks are intermarrying with Aryan women. And that is, you know, it's like love jihad campaigns today. You had the same things. And you had a whole lot of, now who was it they were demonizing? If you read the history, you find that those who were intellectuals, those who were on the left, those who were working class activists and organizers of workers, those who were left leaders, they were the ones who were demonized as the anti-nationals and so on in the run-up to the rise of Hitler in Germany. And that's why I feel that it's not coincidental that the channels you're talking about, which I think of them as being, I don't think of them as being harmless circuses, okay? I think of them as being fascist propaganda channels.
Republic TV has completely unmasked the LOBBY, the lobby. The lobby are the following: people who are lawyers, journalists, professional lobbies, activists, NGO operators, helpers to lawyers, helpers to journalists, some student activists, left liberal media who nobody reads, and some retired, semi-retired members of the Lutyens media who've lost their relevance and hence want to go to Addas often, very often to campuses to feel important. I call these people today the pseudo-liberal lynch mob. The pseudo-liberal social media lynch mob. There is no better way than to put an army tank so that the army tank crushes over the anti-nationals in one sweeping move. It is time today to bring down this last standing bastion of people. They will be isolated. One by one, they will be identified and isolated, and you will say you are being McCarthyist in your thinking. No, sir. You want to call us McCarthyist, so be it.
I must first compliment you, Mr. Arnab Goswami, to create a narrative. You are a master in creating a narrative. You are a master. I must compliment the BJP and RSS leadership to create a narrative.
Money, 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 money. Modi, Modi.
So I think it's so amazing. See, and if you look at Pakistan, see, Pakistan is next door. Pakistan is a bugbear for the right wing here. But you look at Pakistan, look at what the left gets called in Pakistan. It's the same galis. It is the same. They also get called anti-national. They also get called raw agents, just as we get called ISI agents. Okay? You look at what Azma Jahangir was called. It's eggs where she died recently. What she was called is exactly what we get called. Okay? So left ko to jis bhi desh mein ho, us desh ke jo right wing log hain, who are in power, are going to call you those names because they're trying to create an insecure atmosphere for us and they want to discredit us.
you all know it's unfair, right? TV is an unfair medium. You stopped going on almost every TV channel right now.
I didn't stop going because it's unfair. I assume that every place is unfair, from the assemblies to parliament to the streets to everywhere to TV channels. And I'm happy. I can hold my own over there. I'll go. I stopped going because I realized that channels like The Times Now Then and Republic Now and Z and so on, they are basically staging these fascist, these spectacles for fascism. And they need us to go and play a role there. They need us. They don't need us to actually be saying anything there. I realize that if we go, then we are allowing ourselves to be, to enable that spectacle. It's like enabling a domestic abuser. I won't enable it anymore. You know, I stopped being an enabler.
Very rightfully.
I stopped being an enabler.
Because your heart bleeds for Britain and US, from where you get your dollars.
I don't get a single penny or a single dollar from
anywhere. Second. Now I request everyone to be quiet for a minute.
You're calling
you are a bunch of anti-national. You are a bunch of anti-national.
Miss Kavita Krishnan, have some self-respect. You are an Indian, for God's sake. Have some self-respect, Kavita Krishnan. Miss Kavita Krishnan, I'm sorry, but there has to be a limit to bad behavior on television.
Your bad behavior is evident to everyone tonight.
Can I kindly come in?
1 minute, Kavita. Relax, please, Kavita Krishnan. Okay?
You relax.
Take a deep breath.
You do. You need it.
I managed to make myself heard. In fact, a caller in actually endorsed, which Arnab was hoping would go against me. The caller in actually spoke for me. Okay, some caller in said, actually what she said is absolutely right. That the government should be asked, why aren't you doing something for the Adivasis that, you know, Greenpeace or whoever else is Priya Pillai is doing.
Yeah.
So, even though I was heard, I realized that the way they had staged it was so that there was no scope for reasonable discussion there. Reason is not the outcome over there. The outcome is that all that screaming, the general outcome is that they need to paint someone as villain and someone as hero. Okay, and the hero, we all know who the hero is.
Modi, Modi, Modi. I'm sure you'll agree that the Prime Minister hit the ball out of the park for 2019. There was a video the Prime Minister put out today that shows the Prime Minister in a number of yoga postures, etc.
Oh, yeah! You wanna be healthy, wealthy, sexy and wise. Exercise!
You got that right!
You see, when you see this video, you see the Prime Minister sitting on a rock.
Yeah!
The Prime Minister goes backward on a rock, folds his palms to the skies.
Exercise!
You got that right!
This is not about power. This is about how respected the individual is. So Modi is seen as a great statesman across the entire world.
और तुम देखो ना, when Arnab के लिए पहले योगी आदित्यनाथ विलन था, ठीक है, वो योगी को बुलाता था और कहता था ये देखो fringe element है, देखो कितना बदमाश है. You can find n number of footage of him calling. Now the minute Yogi became like the successor to Modi. Then this man suddenly says, अरे देखो विकास कर रहा है, क्या क्या कर रहा है, बहुत अच्छा हो गया वो.
ये योगी आदित्यनाथ तो ऐसे व्यक्ति है, उनको धर्म के बारे में तो कुछ पता ही नहीं है. योगी आदित्यनाथ ऐसे अनपढ़ व्यक्ति हैं. Somebody should tell योगी आदित्यनाथ to get, you know, his mental balance checked.
Thank you very much. बहुत-बहुत धन्यवाद. Thank you so much for joining me, Yogi ji. I'd like to congratulate you on your 100 days in governance.
Thank you. Thank you.
You've had a very, very good track record. अभी आपकी पोजीशनिंग जो है वो है डेवलपमेंट ओरिएंटेड चीफ मिनिस्टर. नाउ पीपल से दैट यू वर्क 18 आवर्स अ डे. मुझे पता नहीं आप दिन में, लोग कहते हैं 18 घंटा काम करते हैं. 24/7 चीफ मिनिस्टर कहा जा रहा है आपको, दैट यू आर अ 24/7 चीफ मिनिस्टर.
और कई सारे सीरियस केस है योगी आदित्यनाथ के खिलाफ अंडर आईपीसी सेक्शंस 147, 148, 153A, 295, 297. दीज आर योगी आदित्यनाथ्स वर्ड्स. इफ आई आस्क फॉर ब्लड, they will give me blood and I will not stop till I turn Uttar Pradesh and India into a Hindu Rashtra.
So jab aap kehte hain ki I will not stop till I turn UP and India into a Hindu Rashtra, you do not mean it will not be a secular state. That is not what you are saying. Main uspe clarification
de. Hindu se bada secular kaun hai?
आपने कंसिस्टेंटली प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी को प्रेज किया है. कई लोग कंपैरिजंस भी ड्रॉ करते हैं. आपकी एक सिग्निफिकेंस है in the BJP, you're an emerging national leader.
And everyone is going to ask now, and Mr. Modi may not like, everyone's going to ask about whether the Modi effect is on the wane. Did the BJP get it all wrong with its choice of Yogi Adityanath?
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। और मेरी हिंदी तो ठीक थी ना?
नहीं, बहुत सुंदर।
थैंक यू, थैंक यू।
मैंने कहा हिपोक्रेसी की भी सीमा होती है।
सो Kavita, I first came to know of you when it was like 6 years back actually, right now, when the horrendous Nirbhaya case happened and you were at the forefront of that movement. And was that your first time you got recognized as an activist in a space which is away from your left-leaning ideologies?
I mean, I was doing what I always did before that and now. Okay, what I do is the same thing even now. But what happened was that was a time at which in the anti-rape movement you had a whole lot of young women especially, and young people in general, who were coming out not just opposing rape. Okay, I think what was most important about that protest was not so much that they spoke out against rape, which a lot of people have done in India even before that, but that they were saying something very important about their autonomy, about don't, in the name of safety, don't take away our autonomy.
Sheila Dikshit ne kaha tha jis samay wo journalist Soumya ki hatya hui thi कि अरे बाप रे, वो 3 बजे रात में निकली थी तो वो ज्यादा एडवेंचरस। तो हम यहाँ कहने आए हैं कि महिलाओं को एडवेंचरस होने का हर अधिकार, हर हक है। हम एडवेंचरस होंगे, हम रेकलेस होंगे, हम रैश होंगे, हम अपनी सुरक्षा के लिए कुछ नहीं करेंगे। हम कैसे कपड़े पहनेंगे ये आप हमें मत बताओ, हमें कितने बजे रात में चलना चाहिए, दिन में कैसे चलना चाहिए, कितने लोगों को साथ लेके चलना चाहिए, ये हमें मत बताओ। लड़कियां अगर अकेले भी निकले, कितने भी बजे रात में निकले, ये पूछा जा रहा है कि जस्टिफिकेशन देने की जरूरत नहीं है कि उनको तो काम से निकलना पड़ता है, वो रिटर्न कर रहे हैं बीपीओ के नौकरी से या मीडिया की नौकरी से। भाई अगर उसकी इच्छा है कि वो रात में निकले, अगर उसकी इच्छा है कि हम रात में जाकर के सिगरेट खरीदे, रात में निकले, रात को जो है बाहर सड़क पर टहले, तो क्या ये इच्छा व्यक्त करना ये कोई गुनाह हो जाएगा?
She can make mistakes, okay? She can do what she likes. She can do what you think is disgusting. She can have, you know, a personal life that you don't like, you think is wrong. But the point is, it's her life. And just to give you an instance of how the rape discourse actually helps to disguise this. There was a study done by a journalist in The Hindu called Rukmini in 2013-14. They studied, for 6 months, they studied rape cases that reached Delhi courts, Delhi's district courts. And they found that 40% of those cases, and imagine those who are talking about false allegation, don't talk about this. 40% of the rape cases that reached the Delhi courts that year were not cases of rape at all, because the woman was not saying she has been raped. They were cases of consensual elopements in which the parents had come and filed rape cases. Mm. Parents of the girl. Okay. So this means that this was, while it's being called rape in the statistics, it's actually disguising another form of violence, which is violence against women's autonomy, right?
दिल्ली पुलिस अगर एड कैंपेन चला रही है महिलाओं पर हिंसा के खिलाफ, क्या एड कैंपेन है आपने देखा होगा, वहाँ आईटीओ पे लगा हुआ है बड़ा सा होर्डिंग और कई जगह देखा होगा, उस एड कैंपेन में महिलाओं की हिंसा के खिलाफ एड कैंपेन है जिसमें एक भी महिला नहीं, कोई महिला नहीं है। उसमें एक मेल फिल्म एक्टर है फरहान अख्तर, जो कह रहे हैं बी अ मैन, कम एंड जॉइन मी इन प्रोटेक्टिंग विमेन, मर्द बनो और आकर के महिलाओं की सुरक्षा करो। मर्दानगी, ये क्या कोई महिलाओं पर होने वाली हिंसा का ये समाधान है या समस्या है, समस्या की जड़ है?
See, my point is that I think of feminism as being enabling even for men, okay? Because I think that while of course men enjoy privilege in a society that is patriarchal, you know, the point is that they also suffer from, you know, stereotypes against men are debilitating for men too. Okay, you are all the expectations from men and the expectations of their behavior. Even the fact that you're expected to be the, you know, the guardians of social morality and, you know, the guardians of your sister and control her freedom, that makes you less of an human being, right? That less of an insan, na?
You're against death penalty in the Nirbhaya case also.
About death penalty, I think of that as a massive... two things, red herring. One is that I don't see it as being, you know, it is not proven to be doing, to have done any good at all in reducing crimes anywhere in the world. Okay, otherwise Saudi Arabia should be the most wonderful country for women. Okay, yeah. Because it has all these barbaric punishments. So you're like, does it help women? It does the opposite. Okay, it's a particularly bad country for women. Huh? And even in countries like the US and all, if you look at states where they have the death penalty and states where they don't, okay, inside the US, you don't find that rape and other crimes are particularly less in states where the death penalty is there. So to me, if you're going to kill somebody, if you're going to take somebody's life away, I see that as being completely unjust. I don't think any of us should have the power to do that, to hand out a death penalty, and the state should not have that right, most definitely.
Death is the only deterrent. Death is the only answer. Death. 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 My view is death.
No.
Death is the only answer.
But what my observation basically is that the left and right are together when it comes to violating rights of women. And in the left parties also, you see that the representation of women is very little, and they behave in the same way as the right would. When it comes to this point, I don't see too much difference between left and right.
I would grant, and I've written about, if you look at the articles I've written, then I've written many articles about left leaders and left organizations indulging in sexism and all kinds of victim blaming against women. Okay, I have called out left leaders for so doing by name of left parties, and I've written about it extensively. But even while writing about it, when I would grapple to think about what exactly is going on here, I would say that when a left leader does this, suppose there's a left leader who looks at Mamata Banerjee and says she hates the left because she is unmarried and doesn't have sindoor in her hair. Okay, this happened. It's a real thing.
They've said much worse also.
But what I'm saying is, suppose somebody says something really grossly sexist and awful. Okay, so you can actually you can shame a left leader based on this. Okay. Whereas, if an RSS chap is saying that Rashtriya Swayamsevika Sangh is actually telling women ki domestic violence ke liye complain mat kiya karo, don't wash your dirty linen out in public. And this guy called Tapan, somebody, Hindu Sanati leader of Bengal, I've kept his tweets, okay, because I find them fascinating. He's tweeted saying, I've just rescued a woman from love jihad in Bengal, and now starts the tough part of getting her to change her mind. Which means you haven't rescued her, no? You abducted her, no? You abducted her from somebody she wants to live with. And you're describing it. Now, the point is, I can't shame him by saying, oh God, you're against women's rights and equality. He'll say, of course I'm against women's rights and equality. I'm thinking of them. I think for me, women are devis. I have to rescue them. And if she's doing her own thing, I have to rescue her from herself. That's something an RSS guy will say, an Hindu Samhati guy will say with pride. I can't shame him based on that. If a left leader says such a thing, I can shame his organization based on that and make sure that they, sanction him in some way.
Bharatiya Janata Party MP Bansilal Mahato has triggered outrage across Chhattisgarh after he said the girls in the state are becoming tanatan.
Rajiv Gandhi, who is Nigerian, ladies se biyah ki hote. Gori chamra naam tha to kya Congress party usko netritsv karti kya?
Even Nigeria has taken offence.
I think the remarks by the Honourable Minister were uncalled for.
Outrageous comments made by Congress MP and President Pranab Mukherjee's son Abhijit Mukherjee about the protesters in Delhi. He went on to say these pretty ladies are highly dented and painted. I doubt how many of these women are students. It's a fashion, he said, for a section of the community to hold protest marches just like visiting a discotheque.
Char ko rape kar diya, kabhi aisa ho sakta kya? Aisa practical bhi nahi hai.
That was Mulayam Yadav's second shocking sexist statement. A year after his infamous boys will be boys analogy,
आप मुझे बताइए भैया हमारे गरीब देश में ये 50 करोड़ की गर्लफ्रेंड 50 करोड़ की गर्लफ्रेंड.
But there comes another parliamentary shift that we need to go through then is do we need women reservation?
Yeah, I've always argued for that. For the simple reason that I don't I think that representation is so low in India that you need to create a situation where there is a slightly somewhat better representation. I'm saying, for instance, the university where I studied, JNU, in the early 90s, the union that was the first union I voted for and elected was the union of my organization, the ISA, that had managed to achieve deprivation points for women. What does deprivation points mean? Okay, it was like a positive discrimination where you say that women actually have a higher degree of deprivation that they face. So for women to find time to study, okay, because women will often come from backgrounds where they'll be told, acha, tumko khana bhi banana hai, chote bachon ka bhi dekbhal karo, do a lot of other things that men are not called upon to do. Or they may not be allowed to study in the as good schools. So the boy may go to a better school, the girl may not go to such a good school. So once they reach university level, in that entry level, you need help. Now my point is for any reservation, be it caste reservation or gender deprivation points or anything like that, the argument that this is against merit is something I find very laughable. Because people say, doctor kaise banenge? Achche doctor nahi banenge. And I'm saying, but the exit point is the same, no? The exit exam where people get their degree is the same. They're all getting, they're all, there's no reservation there. You're qualifying for the same exam. It's only at the entry level that you're helping people enter spaces that have been closed off to them, you know, for various reasons. Acha, it's a strange thing, even in liberal circles, which I see, you know, recently I've been seeing on social media and all also people saying this kind of thing. Saying if you are a minority or a Dalit who feels insecure in India today, or if you are a Hindu who feels that the, you know, Muslims are dangerous people in India today, then both of you need to stop being on social media, look around you, look at how nice India is and everybody's friends. And I was like, no, this is a liberal fallacy, right? You have to recognize that Hindus being told that they have to be afraid of minorities and afraid of caste equality, afraid of reservations is a falsehood. Whereas minorities or Dalits facing violence because of their identity, even women facing violence because they're women, is a reality, all right? So you can't put both on par and say both are fake, you know?
Yeah, but that's actually a good note to end on.
Yeah, it's a pleasure and having spoken to you. I enjoyed it.
And thanks so much to have agreed to come on the show. But if you ever meet Sunit Chopra, please tell him to not go on Republic TV as a plea.
What did you say?
Not come from China.
No, no, no. What did you say? What did you say? What did you say? One second. What did you say? What did you say?
I said it.
What did you say?
Kauwa jab mor ke pankh pehnega, to mor nahi ban jaega.
Apologize. Apologize. No, you cannot use those words. And for using words like kauwa, do you believe that Sunit Chopra should issue an apology? I think he should right here live on the program tonight. कौवा अगर मोर के पंख पहने तो कौवा रहेगा दिस इज द काइंड ऑफ लैंग्वेज विच यू यूज
दिस इज अ रेसिस्ट कमेंट
यस
दिस इज टारगेटेड एट द बैकवर्ड कम्युनिटीज
सबके सामने गाली गंदी गंदी गाली बच्चों के सामने बच्चे देखते हैं ये टेलीविजन मैं भी गाली दे सकती हूँ हिंदी में आई कैन इवन गिव गालीज इन इटालियन
कोई बात नहीं मैंने लैटिन पढ़ी हुई है आपकी गंदी गालियां मेरे को कुछ नहीं करेंगी
You are a B team of the Congress, which is embarrassing, but then say we are.
You are the B team of the BJP.
Hey, shut up, yeah, Kunal.
Shut up, yeah, Kunal.
Shut up,
yeah, Kunal.
Shut up, yeah, Kunal.
Hey, shut up, Kunal.
Not gone into any Modi bashing. Would you like to detach from it so that. Like, should we discuss Modi? I don't want to.
यहाँ लॉजिक के बदले में सोल्जर मिलता है वो खोरे जो उसको ऑरेंज लड्डू मिलता है यही देश नहीं जुमलों की रेस है इसमें सच नहीं किया कैमोफ्लेज फेस है देखो मैंने अब सवाल करने छोड़ दिए हैं मैंने तेज भागने को नए जूते लिए हैं मेरे सारे सपने धीरे धीरे मर रहे हैं
याचिन में हमारे जवान लड़ रहे हैं